Do you have an addiction? Is it interfering with your life? Well, in this video, we're going to be looking at what causes addiction and what are the symptoms of addiction, so that by the end of this video, you'll understand exactly why you or somebody you love might be struggling with addiction. G'day there, I'm Jesse Crow, the traveling scientist, and after spending years studying pharmacology, I'm here to help you live smarter, happier, and healthier lives. In my last video, I shared an interesting story about the scientific research into addiction, and it might help you understand this video a little bit better, and you can check that out, it's just up here. Did you check it out? No? Okay. Well, let me know if you've struggled with addiction before in the comments section down below, because honestly, addiction is super common, and you are not alone. And if you want some more information on dealing with addiction, I've made an e-booklet all about it. It's totally free and it's in the description just down below. But right here, right now, I'm going to answer some key questions about addiction, starting with this. An addiction is something that feels good in the short term and causes negative consequences in the long term, but you keep doing it anyway. If you do something like that, you might be an addict. And here are the top 10 most common addictions of the Western world. You got smoking, alcohol, weed, painkillers, cocaine and heroin, excessive eating, gambling, porn, video games, and yes, social media. Can you relate to any of these? I know I can. If you do any of these things a little bit too much, you might be addicted without even realizing it. But what causes these addictions? Stress. Some people are stressed and they don't even realize it. Whether it's your job, your family, your friends, or even your environment, there's a bunch of things that can promote cortisol production, which makes you feel stressed. It's your parents, isn't it? It's always the parents. Damn you, mom and dad. How do people deal with stress? Smoking, drinking, drugs, and all those other addictions I just talked about. They help to distract you from your stressful life and replace cortisol, the stress hormone, with dopamine, a reward hormone. And you might do it just in small amounts, but some people can't control themselves.
I love chocolate, but I can't eat it because then I'll get fat.
Trauma. People who have a traumatic past are more likely to suffer from addiction. Whether you were neglected or assaulted or even worse, certain activities can help you to relax, forget about your past, and give you a feeling of control in your life. But the truth is that you're not in control of an addiction. It controls you and only makes things worse in the long run. And finally, genetics. Stress and trauma are both environmental factors, but your genetics also affects your susceptibility to addiction. And unfortunately, you don't have much control over this one. Look at your immediate family, your parents or your siblings. Do they struggle with addiction? Because their level of addiction might have a direct impact on your own addictive behaviors. Always the parents. Damn you again, mom and dad. There are a lot of symptoms for addiction, but I just want to highlight six of them right here, right now. Craving. You want it. You really want it. And that desire is strong and it's almost always there. Loss of control. You know that you shouldn't, but screw it. You just do it anyway. Health issues. Most addictions are bad for you. If it's substance abuse, it's damaging your body. And if it's an activity like getting stuck into gambling or social media, it's probably distracting you from taking care of your body. Relationship troubles. People often put their addictions ahead of their friends, their family, and even their partners, which can be really damaging to your social life. Loss of money. Addiction usually costs something. In some cases, it's a large portion of your money. And just imagine what you could do with that money if it didn't get spent on your addiction. And finally, work and study issues. Addiction can usually interfere with your work or your studies, causing you to fail at your job and at school. In conclusion, certain activities can help people to cope with life and forget their problems. But if you do it too much, you might be addicted. Addiction can be triggered by stress or a traumatic past, or you might simply have an addictive personality. Whatever the reason, if you're craving something and you can't control yourself, certain addictions can lead to health problems, social dilemmas, and money issues, ultimately causing more stress and making everything even worse. Addiction is a vicious cycle, and I want to help you and the people you love to break that cycle. In next week's video, we're going to be looking at what you can do to treat your addiction and help the people that you know who might also struggle with addiction. By taking control of it, you can regain control of your life and start living smarter, happier, and healthier. Anyway, guys, that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video or learned something, click the like button down below. And let me know if you're familiar with any of these causes or symptoms of addiction in the comment section down below. Finally, next week's video is going to be all about 5 different ways you can treat addiction. So make sure you subscribe for more Traveling Science every single week. And I'll see you guys next Science Sunday. Cheers. Did you check it out? No? Okay, cool. They help to distract you. If you do anything, people often put their addiction at front, which can cause some serious social...